This is really exciting. I posted something on Twitter a while ago about a really crazy number with a lot of digits that are all the same, and it got a really huge response. I just want to share with you my experience with this number. Let me draw the number for you. 12, 13. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Whoa. And in the words of Andrew Wiles, I think I'll stop there. This number here, all nines, you can see it. In actual fact, the way that you'd describe this is as a rep digit. So in the maths canon, you'd say rep digit, meaning repeated digit. But what's special about this, there's two things really special about this number, is that here, down here, there's one digit that's changed.
So it's not a rep digit?
It's called a near rep digit. So it's just really close. But you know what I like to call it, Brady? I like to call it a glitch. I feel like it's a glitch because it's not only a glitch number, believe it or not, this is a prime number. This here, I posted this on Twitter. It really got people going. But you know what I thought, Brady? I thought, you sure they haven't made a mistake? I'd really like to check this number, you know? As a mathematician, that's what you want to do. You want to check it. The only problem is, how do you check a number like this? I really don't suggest you stick this into the Google entry line. To actually work out if it was a prime or not, I actually needed to compactify it. I mean, I needed to actually go... I needed to actually transform it into something that I could carry around. So this number has 506 digits. And so the 8 here is actually, if you count from the bottom, from the 1s column and the 10s column and the 100s column, if you get up, you'll actually get to the 254th column. So it's actually 254 along. So it's just over the halfway. How can we actually transport this in a way that doesn't involve me writing out all these 9s? Any ideas? What's really cool about it is the fact that they are 9s. So if you add 1 to 9, you get a 10. And if you add 1 to 99, you get 100. And if you add 1 to 999, you get 1,000. So we can actually use that fact, because if we can actually get this as something to the power of 10, well, that can really make things a lot easier for us to handle. So if we think about it, right, this has 506 nines. So if we say 10 take 1 is 9, 10 squared take 1, which is 100 take 1, is 99, and 10 cubed, which is 3 zeros there, take 1 is 999. Then if we go dot, 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 and you've got to love the dot, dot, dots, because you can put anything in dot, dot, dots. We can then say 10 to the 506 take 1 is equal to, let's just jump to the chase, hey Brody, is equal to 999 dot, 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 999, where this happens to be 506 digits.
Yep.
So that's kind of that, except for that.
I know it's a small change, but that actually changes the value of the number quite a lot, doesn't it?
What do you mean, changes the value?
The quantity, like if you were going to buy that many eggs...
you were going to put this into eggs?
Changing that from an 8... For changing that from a 9 to an 8.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Dramatically changed the number of eggs you just bought.
Well, you know what? You're exactly right. And to actually work out by how much, you're actually solving the problem. 9 take 8 is 1. 90 take 80, it's 10. 900 take 800 is 100. Can you see the pattern going on here? So if we actually think there's a 9 right there in the 254th position, so what would that mean? That means that we're actually taking away 1 with this many zeros. So we've got to imagine there's a 1 here, and then it's got all, for every 9 there's basically a 0, because that's continuing what's going on here. So now what we're doing is we go 10 to the 506 take 1 gives us this C of nines. And then we just want to take one with a whole bunch of zeros to kind of get it up to that point there. So we're basically taking away 10 to the 253. So that's what that's equal to. So it's that, take one to give us the nines, take that to take one away from that spot. So yeah, so I found a way to actually carry it around and talk to you. This is the way you talk to big numbers, big prime numbers like this, to your friends. You don't go 9999999999 in some sort of Ali G for reference.
9999999999.
Which is interesting. In actual fact, Ali G does this thing where he goes, what's 99999 take 99999989999999. He actually does this, and I actually counted the number of times he said nines and eights.
8999999.
And it's unbelievable. He's like one off, one place off actually having one of these glitch primes. That would have really made the nerds excited. So now what we have is a way to actually understand this number. So now we have 10 to the 506. Take, and I'm just going to order it in terms of magnitude here. Take that. Take that. Basically, what you need to notice here, what's going on, is the fact that if you double 253, 253, guess what you get? 2 3's a 6, 225's a... it's actually that number. So now we can actually find a structure. So I'm going to put in a couple of letters here to denote other things. So I can actually make it even smaller if you check this out. Maybe not, because in actual fact, for M... don't you love mathematicians? Let's just make it more complicated. So in actual fact, it actually has this shape. So what happened next? I started doing this at 9 p.m. I mean, I was still doing it at 6 a.m. I mean, I was going down, this is the hole I want to take you down. So now, what's really interesting is that if you learn about how to factorize polynomials or even, you know, factorize things, because this is actually 10m squared, take 10m, take 1. So you kind of get this taught at school, you know. It actually has the shape of x squared, take x, take 1. So you could actually think, oh, maybe I'm going to be able to work out a way to see when this is a prime or not. But see, this is what's amazing about these primes. Primes don't act that way. In actual fact, I needed to put this number into like a database that would crunch it for me. And you wouldn't believe there's only a small number of m's which will actually give you this particular shaped glitch prime. And they happen to be for values of m, where m is equal to 1, 6, 9, 154, 253, hello, 1,114, and 1,390. And that's as far as the database went. And I think that's probably as far as we know at this point for this particular. So look at that. Think about how big this number is, how many values of M you can have. And it's only for these numbers that this will be prime. And that happens to be prime. What's cooler than just a glitch?
No glitch.
Well, maybe. But maybe also, what happens if the glitch was right in the middle of the number? So, I actually looked into that as well. So that's a different formula. So that formula then is, we're saying it's 10 to the 2m plus 1, take 10m, take 1. It basically has to be an odd number of digits. Not an odd number, but in terms of the number of digits, it has to be an odd number because it has to have a middle. So there are lots of different values for that, but there's actually a really nice value. The first one we can find is actually m equals 9. And so what it looks like is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, 8, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it's 9 nines, 8 9 nines. Come on, swish. But see, I looked at this and I thought, glitch. What are glitches? We think glitches, we think computers, we think binary. So really, where this took me to was like, I'm looking at these glitch primes the wrong way. I should be looking at binary glitch primes. So I want to look at binary numbers. So in that fact, in that case, I'm looking at, instead of nines, I'm looking at 1111111, glitch 11111. And also, let's just think about the coolest thing, a palindrome. And they've actually got a special name. They're called Cyclops numbers. So, for example, 5 is 101. Cyclops, because it's got a hole in the middle. But you've got lots of other Cyclops numbers. I mean, I don't even have to work it out. You could have like 2 ones and a zero and 2 ones, whatever that is. Or you could have 3 ones and a zero, 3 ones, or you could have like 4 and a zero and 4. I mean, this is getting, you know, we're really, I mean, this is the sort of stuff you communicate with aliens about, you know what I mean?
5 is prime. Are those other ones prime?
Well, that was my question. I wanted to know if other ones could be prime. And this is really where my mind was blown. Because I then had to change the structure of this thing here. It's 10 because it's base 10. But if we actually do it like this, so if then if it's 2m, because we're basically doing it in binary, so that just means that we need to do it in power 2, right? What that means is, this is unbelievable, I'm able to actually factorize this into 2m plus 1 plus 1 to 2m take 1. So you're always able to do that because it's 2. You can't do that with any other number higher than 2. And this is a problem because guess what? Primes, by definition, don't have any factors. They don't have any factors. It's just only divisible by themselves and 1. So if you can actually turn this always into this, the only time this is not going to be a prime is when one of these things is equal to 1. So this is getting added. It has to be 2m take 1 equals 1. So then that means it's 2m equals 2. Well, come on. It's m equals 1. So that means it's that means the only prime we have is 2 to the power 2 plus 1, 5. So where this took me, unbelievable, the morning, the sun's rising, and I realize, maybe I'm the first person to realize, I'm not really, but that's how I feel about maths, that the only glitch prime you can have in binary is 101.
We'd like to thank audible.com for their support of this Numberphile episode. If you want to enjoy a book or other spoken material, Audible has everything you could wish for. They've got over 180,000 titles to choose from, and they're offering a 30-day free trial when you sign up for the service. Now, if you're in the mood for some more mathematics, I can highly recommend these books on the screen, including Alex's Adventures in Numberland and The Mathematics of Love, both by people who appear in Numberphile videos. Or if all this talk about Cyclops has you excited, why not go old school and listen to none other than The Odyssey by Homer? Not that Homer. If you do check out Audible, and I highly recommend it, I use Audible myself, then use the URL audible.com/numberphile. That means if you do take them up on that free trial, the good people there will know you came from here. That's audible.com/numberphile. And our sincere thanks to them for helping us make more Numberphile videos.